My family are pre-Windrush generation who immigrated to the UK for wealth and opportunities. However, the UK is an unequal society and inequality is growing. In fact, the UK is one of the most unequal societies in the OECD, and this is despite being the fifth richest country globally by GDP per capita. Significant economic disparities exist between ethnic minorities within the UK, and uniquely for Africans and Caribbeans, this is despite many of the common barriers, for example, language barriers, religious beliefs, regional location, and in the case of Africans, educational levels being absent. Increased globalization sees a significant demographic shift in the UK, which could further increase inequality, particularly for those already on the margins of society. Financial inclusion can be described as people and businesses accessing and using the formal financial service system for economic development and addressing issues of social exclusion, self-determination, and poverty alleviation. Much of the existing literature focuses on issues of people's personal characteristics rather than the cultural characteristics, and as such, progress has slowed. So there's still an estimated 1.2 million people remaining unbanked in the UK and a further 8 million people underbanked. Furthermore, there is a lack of heterogeneous data relating to financial inclusion in the UK, and as such, policymakers often take the scattergun approach to addressing financial inclusion rather than focusing on those communities and groups that need help the most. So my research will start by conducting a systematic literature review to synthesize and delineate key components of financial inclusion to support the development of a more financially intelligent approach to addressing financial exclusion. Next, I will conduct a qualitative study to adapt the OECD's financial inclusion and financial literacy studies to understand the scale of financial inclusion, but also to understand the cultural elements that determine economic outcomes and to understand why some people self-exclude from the system altogether. Finally, I will evaluate the economic impact of financial exclusion on ethnic communities and consider a new model for identifying who is incorrectly self-excluded from the system and how to empower them to make better financial decisions. This research has broad appeal because for the first time, a solution for assessing the suitability of self-exclusion can be employed, and perhaps the ostensible goal of achieving 100% inclusion to the formal financial system can be disregarded for a more financially intelligent modus operandi that contributes to addressing levels of inequality in the UK.